Hey guys, this is Damon Hart, the Foxy Home Buyer, coming to you from my office here with a few tips if you're in a situation where you need to get your ex off your current loan because of a divorce. This is how you do it. There's only a few options that I would recommend here. If you're in a situation, having an ex is bad enough, right? Sometimes you don't want to deal with that person and things are kind of weird. You obviously don't want to have any financial ties. So a lot of times when I deal with folks that are in divorce situations, they want to know how to get out of the divorce. So I'm going to give you a few ways that you can do that pretty easily without having to go through too much stress. First option is, obviously selling the home, right? If you can sell it, whether the home may need some repair or you just like, okay, well, I just want to get out of this thing and move on to the next part of my life. No one's going to be tied to it after that. You can just sell it, to someone like through a real estate agent or to a private investor like myself and our company. Okay. Now, the other option would be doing something like a refinance. Now, I was in that business for years, and it's one of those things where if you can refinance the other person that's no longer going to live in the house and wants to assume the financial responsibility, just refinance the house, stay in the house, don't have to move. And this works out really great in a situation where, let's say, both parties that were married are working. The person that's staying in the home can afford the payments just by refinancing. Boom, you're out altogether, and that person can move on to their separate part of their life. And if you have children or what have you, they can stay in the home that they always knew. So that works out to be a really great option. The other one, it's a little under the radar, but a lot of people don't know what it's called, but it's a release of liability. Now, depending on the lender, they might not be too big on offering you this option, but a release of liability is kind of like a refinance where you would just go to the actual mortgage company and say, hey, listen, my ex doesn't want any more responsibility. We have separation. Here's all the documentation. If I would take on all the responsibility, would you then waive the responsibility on the other party, have it all legally drafted, and get it all done? Okay, that's a really stealth, under the radar type of a solution, but it's available. You just have to check with your lender on how to do it. Now, the other is a loan modification. Sometimes this one's really popular. If you're going to stay in the home, and maybe you're a little bit upside down and you're having a little bit of difficulty as far as the payment. You feel like the payment could be worked out better in your favor if you're going to stay in the home. You can approach your lender again and say, hey, let me get a loan modification. Loan mods are really all they do is restructure your loan. Okay, modification, right? They just restructure the loan so that it works to something you can afford. And in doing that, you can also request that they release the party that's no longer going to stay in the property to get them off of the mortgage that way. Okay, kind of stealthy, right? I like it. Stuff that you wouldn't normally hear about, but here we're Foxy, so we tell you all that that's available to you. The other is a little old school, but what happens a lot of times with government loans like VA, you can also assume that mortgage if you want to stay in it and get the other person off. So it's kind of like a refinance, if you will, but with assuming, you don't have to pay all those costs up front. You just assume the loan and be on to the next thing. So that's pretty cool. And and then I guess the most practical, right? I guess my last solution would be, listen, if things go separate and you got enough bank staying in the home and you want to just get both parties out, what do? Right? You just pay off the mortgage. You just go into your little bank account, pay off the mortgage, say see you later, and now you're all set. So those are really just the best options that I have available when working with a divorce and want to get the ex off of the note mortgage. That's the best way to do it. So I hope this was helpful. Please like and share this to anyone that you think might get any benefit from this. And always remember to connect with us if you have any questions. We'd love to share with you. We buy houses. We buy houses pretty ugly, but we do it more than just offering you low wall cash offers. We can offer you a deal on your home and buy it in a way that you win and we win. So with that in mind, I want to let you guys know, thanks for tuning in. Until the next one, this is Damon Hart, the Foxy Home Buyer, letting you know to keep it cool and keep it foxy. See you guys. Bye for now.